Money. We'd all like some more money. And in these economic times, how about turning your website into an extra stimulus payment? Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for tuning in. Money. We are all interested in money, and we are all interested in working and having a business that can provide us our livelihood. And if you are a creative entrepreneur, and specifically this time I'm really talking directly to florists, floral designers, and people that own full-service flower shops, we really want whatever our creative outlet is to be our moneymaker. And for so many of we florists, that comes by way of our websites. And if you haven't been keeping track of where your business is coming from, more than likely, depending on how established your business is, for a good majority of us, I would say a good 85 to 90% of your business is online. And if you are not getting that much business online, that's where your problem is. Because now more than ever, especially during these crazy times we find ourselves in right now throughout the world, people are conducting their lives and doing what they need to do online. They are not going to your actual shop to purchase something. They are wanting to do it online. And secondarily to that, they're using their mobile device to do their shopping online. So that means either their phone or an iPad, something to that extent that they are doing their online shopping with. So it's really important to have your website fine-tuned and focused specifically to generate that stimulus money. When it comes to websites for florists, it's crazy business. Historically, florists a lot of us have come from a full-service brick-and-mortar background, and quite likely a shop that did a lot of traditional wire service work when it comes to getting business in the door and by way of the computer and the internet, online, etc. Now, I probably should tell you a little bit more about myself so that you get to know me, so you know that I'm not just a fly-by-night person that's trying to tout all of these things to do, and I'm not just a newbie who happens to understand how all of this website stuff works. Frank Blanchard, AIFD. So right off the bat, yes, I have letters after my name. I am accredited through the American Institute of Floral Designers. That aside, I've worked in the industry for over 30 years. That does not mean I am old and outdated. It just means I know a thing or two about the floral industry and how it works and how it does not work. So I might make a few enemies with this one, but I really want to share with people information that I know works so that it benefits you. Because ultimately, my end-all be-all nowadays with this business is seeing other people be successful with their creative career in the floral industry. So what I'm telling you is true, and I'm telling you because I want you to be successful. So keep that in mind. So I had mentioned that a lot of florists come from a background of dealing with and doing a good majority of their business by means of the traditional wire services. And for many florists, that also means they have their website created and hosted by those wire services. Nowadays, there are a lot more choices available to be able to create your own website, have somebody know, create a website for you. Just kind of depends on what kind of a business you're trying to create for yourself. And if you are doing floral deliveries on a daily basis, or that's what you're shooting for, I would say more likely than not, you're doing it by means of having what's considered to be an e-commerce website. Now, this is where things get kind of sticky when it comes to having a website that works really well. If you've been following my last videos, if you haven't, I would definitely refer back to them. I will put links to them in the comments below. But I've been talking a lot about specific SEO information, search engine optimization, for a floral service or flower shop website. I've talked a lot about digital marketing, social media marketing, all of that, and it all relates. And in order to really get your website generating funds and money for you and getting those sales and building that web traffic, you've got to get all of these moving parts working together and working well. Now, today I specifically wanted to point out some things that I think every florist can really work on to fine-tune their website, specifically an e-commerce website, to target your demographic and your market of clientele in your immediate area. Now, an e-commerce website, one of the key factors for an e-commerce website is it's got to be mobile friendly. I would say the vast majority of all your online business, if you really look at it, is coming from somebody's phone or iPad and not a desktop computer. So if your website is not mobile friendly, I have to say this, you're screwed. You just have to fix that. No ifs, ends, or buts. You have to fix that. And one of the ways that a website can become not mobile friendly is the fact that it takes too dang long for your website to load onto somebody's phone because it takes up so much bandwidth and memory to do it. And one of the biggest causes of that I see when I look at florist websites, and I look at a lot of florist websites on a lot of different platforms all over the place, and it's the same scenario for just about every single one. You've got too dang much on your website. It used to be that with the traditional wire services, when you had a website hosted by that wire service, you just kind of automatically had the entire selection guide from that wire service on your website. And what I'm finding nowadays is there are a lot of florists, if they don't really understand the internet and how it works, and they haven't really learned how e-commerce has evolved, they're still kind of in that mode. And consequently, they just have way too much on your website. And consequently, that alone makes your website load really slowly. And what happens when your website loads slowly is your bounce rate goes through the roof. In other words, people get to your site, you get web traffic, but they don't stay there. They leave. And it's because they don't want to wait any longer for your stuff to load. So, one of the things that you can really do to streamline your website and really focus and target your demographic, number one is to really look at what are the most popular items on your website. Of those items, really look at each one and try to determine what is it about those items that are popular. Why do people gravitate to those items? It might be color, it might be design, it might be because of the container it's in. Who knows? You never really know why people really choose what they do, but you want to try and figure out what it is about certain items that people are selecting. And once you do that, that's what you want to think about doubling down on. Make a few other things that are similar to that item and put those items on your website. The more you can focus on your own design work and not items from a selection guide, you're going to be way ahead. The longer you have items, and I hate to say this, the longer you have items from any selection guide that is not your own work, it's just going to take you a whole lot longer to achieve the amount of business that you would like to have. That's just the way it is. And a lot of it has to do with a lot of other topics that I'm not even talking about in this video. But if you can really focus on your own design work, creating your own design work, determining what items you have on your website are your top sellers, determine why are they your top sellers, and then double down on those items. You want to think about trying to have your website narrowed down to maybe 4, possibly 5 pages worth of items. But even that can be a little much depending on how many items you have listed on a page, but the fewer the better. You really want to target your market and target your demographic with the designs that they gravitate to. So that's a big one to fine-tune your website with. The other thing is to, and this is where it makes it a lot easier when you don't have so much on your website, is you've got to really fine tune and really get your text content on your website spot on. It has to be working and it has to be hitting on all of those levels with a good amount of word content and word count. You can't have descriptions on your items that's just one line. That doesn't cut it. And you've also got to get your keywords working. So frequently I see websites that either have one line of text for a description on an item and that's it. They might not even have a name for that item. Those are key things. You've got to have a name for that item, preferably a name that's got keywords in it. And you've got to have a good description. I would say if you can generate a description for each item on your website that's 3 to 4 paragraphs, not long paragraphs, but decent sized paragraphs with a nice word count, that would be really good. The other key factor is really making sure that you're using keywords. When I do web audits from other people's websites, I oftentimes see people's websites that have huge word count and they have a lot of keywords, and it just on the graph, it's way up there towards the top. The only problem is the keywords that people are searching for the most is the fine little line at the bottom. So all of these other words at the top aren't doing you anything. They aren't doing you any good. So you've really got to focus in on making sure that when you are using keywords and long tail keyword phrases, that you're using terms that people actually search for. So you can't get on your high horse and say, I only do floral design, because floral is not a word that ranks all that well. Flowers does, or the word flower. And for most people, the average Joe and Josephine on the street, when they're searching, they're gonna be searching for flower arrangements. They are not going to be searching for floral design. Think of terms of how are the people on the street going to search for what you do and the services that you provide. So when it comes to e-commerce, and creating that extra cash because you're getting more web traffic that actually converts into a buying customer, you'll want to fine-tune that website. So really narrow down the number of items that you have on your website. Fine-tune all of your text content in the descriptions and the names of your items. And that's going to help immensely. If you can just focus on that for starters, you're gonna be way ahead, because all of a sudden, one of the first things that's gonna happen is the load time for your website for people on a mobile device is going to greatly increase, and you're gonna bring your bounce rate down. Okay, so you're wanting to bring your bounce rate down and your conversion rate to go up. So we're wanting to turn those people into buying customers. So that's your homework right now, to turn your website into your own stimulus payment with more buying customers. Fine-tune those selections on your e-commerce website and work on those descriptions and titles. And until next time, lot more to share with you specifically on that topic, as well as design inspiration and marketing tips. If you liked this content, I should say, definitely hit that subscribe button and give it a like. If you hit that bell icon so that you get notifications when I do upload a new video, that would be great. And until next time, I look forward to seeing you soon. And if you've got any questions, by all means, drop me a line in the comments below. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.